from Studio A, this is WGAL8 Brain Busters. Now, here's your host, Rich Rosen.
Well, hello, everybody, and welcome aboard once again for WGAL8 Brain Busters. We've had some great games over the past several weeks, and today it's up to Lancaster Mennonite and Central Dauphin, two newcomers. One team will return for round two. Who will it be? Well, let's start finding out now, because here comes today's opening round. We have 10-point questions and one big brain buster brought to you by Turkey Hill. Welcome to all six of you. Let's get to work now with this 10-point question. The World Cup in Qatar was not short on surprises, especially when the team led by Lionel Messi lost to Saudi Arabia.
Argentina.
Argentina is the powerhouse team's loss in what is a huge early upset. In 1887, his brother was hanged for plotting against Tsar Alexander II. In 1895, he was sent into exile and didn't return until 1917. Orion again.
Vladimir Lenin.
He's the one for another 10 points. In 1952, Life magazine devoted an entire issue to this novel before it was published as a book. For what book did Ernest Hemingway win the 1953 Pulitzer Prize for fiction? And that's Orion.
Old Man and the Sea.
You are correct. Good for you. Three in a row. In 2000, four of them made it from the comic book to the big screen. Wolverine, Rogue, Mystique, and Storm. Sim.
X-Men.
The X-Men were the mutants, and that gets Lancaster Mennonite on the board. Maycomb, Alabama is the setting for this novel, featuring Orion.
To Kill a Mockingbird.
To Kill a Mockingbird is featuring Atticus Scout and Boo Radley. It's an extremely luminous, active galactic nucleus. What astronomical object of very high luminosity is powered by gas spiraling at high... Orion.
Nebula.
Not nebula, no, sorry. I'm going to complete the question for Lancaster Mennonite. They're spiraling at high velocity into a large black hole. Henry.
Quasar.
Quasars is the correct response. The enumeration in the Constitution of certain rights shall not be construed to deny or disparage others held by the people. Which amendment to the Bill of Rights is this? Henry again.
Four.
It is not the fourth, I am so sorry. Central Dauphin, Orion.
First Amendment?
No, it is the Ninth Amendment. It was used as a legal basis for the Dobbs decision recently. She sank 65 Union ships before being sunk in a spectacular fight with the Kearsarge. What was the ship named for a Confederate state? Orion.
Virginia.
Not the Virginia, no. Good guess, though. Lancaster Mennonite. It was the Alabama, the CSS Alabama. A right angle is equal to 90 degrees. What is a straight angle equal to? Connor.
180 degrees.
180 degrees, by definition, it's a straight line. And now it's time for the big brain buster, brought to you by Turkey Hill. For 10 points and a gift certificate for Turkey Hill ice cream for everyone on the team. GaryCon is a gaming convention held each year in Lake Geneva, Wisconsin, where Gary Gygax, invented this popular role-playing game. Orion.
Dungeons and Dragons.
Dungeons and Dragons is correct. Congratulations, Central Dauphin. His real name is Mr. Edward Bear, but he is better known by another name in the stories of A.A. Milne. Who is he, Orion?
Winnie the Pooh.
He's Winnie the Pooh, yes. They're electromagnetic radiation with wavelengths ranging from a nanometer to a picometer. They can be detected with phosphor screens and photographic plates. What kind of rays are they? Henry.
Light.
No, sorry, incorrect. Orion.
X-rays.
They are X-rays. It's the large order of insects that includes butterflies and moths. What is it? We stumped you on Lepidoptera. The Latin name of our genus and species can be translated as wise guy. What is this two-word Latin term? Oh, Owen.
Homo sapiens.
You are correct for 10 points. Rosalind is the largest woman's role in any of Shakespeare's play. In what play does Rosalind disguise herself as a man? Henry?
Hamlet.
Not Hamlet, no, sorry. Central Dauphin, Orion.
Cyrano?
No, it was As You Like It. The trombone and the tuba are wind instruments. To what group of instruments do the koto, the dulcimer, and the balalaika belong? Orion.
String
instruments? They're all string instruments, yes. It's the only integer which cannot be the denominator of a fraction. Orion.
Zero.
Zero is the correct answer. Guard, league, velvet, enquirer, geographic. What word can precede them all? And that's Orion.
National.
Orion, you are dominating the buzzer, and you are correct. It may be the most symbolic bird in all of literature. What bird does the sailor kill in Rime of the Ancient Mariner? Orion.
Albatross.
An albatross is correct. The nobles of the north supported the House of Lancaster. The middle-class towns of the south supported the Duke of York. The war, Orion.
War of the Roses.
The War of Roses lasted from 1455 to 1485. His paintings of the seascapes include the Lifeline, the Northeaster, and Gulf Stream. Who was this popular artist of the late 19th century? Henry.
Rockwell.
Not he, no, sorry. Great guess though, Orion.
Salvador Dali.
No, he was Spanish surrealist. Winslow Homer is the correct answer. In 1416, he established an observatory and a school on Capes St. Vincent. We were going for Henry the Navigator. Well, that's now takes us to the end of the round. Gives us a chance to collect our breath, and that's a good thing, because we have a lot more game coming up, including the one-on-one rapid fire and team lightning rounds when WGALA Brainbusters continues following this.
WGALA Brainbusters will return after this. Participants on WGAL 8 Brainbusters each receive a portable power bank for mobile devices. And the top four winning teams will share grants totaling $10,000. So good luck, teams. Now, here's Rich with our coaches and alternates.
Mr. Matt Spurrier is the coach from Lancaster Mennonite. This is his first time coaching the team. He's the math teacher there, and we really appreciate him being here. So let's find out a little bit about him. The Summers. What do you do over the summer?
Well, I like spending more time with my family. I also enjoy getting to do things that I don't have time or energy for. And I like having more time to smoke meats, that is.
and of course, you're always preparing for the upcoming year.
Yes, definitely, and taking classes and just being ready.
Right, yep. And the challenges that teachers are confronted with today to enlighten and enrich students. Lancaster Mennonite brought three alternates, so let me introduce all three of them to you. First, we have Fong T. Lee, a senior. Welcome. And Ashton Jobs, and you're a junior. And the youngest of the group is Antonio De La Rosa, a freshman. We welcome all three of you, and we hope to see you come back and perhaps compete as players on the next show or upcoming season. Now let's move over to Central Dauphin, and we're going to meet today's coach, and this is Mr. Jeffrey Deveney. And he has multiple roles. He's an environmental science, chemistry teacher, earth system, so you get to meet a lot of different students. So, young man here, rather new to the teaching, what inspired you or how did you get into the teaching career?
So I really became interested in it when I took chemistry in high school, and I had an aptitude for chemistry and a lot of my friends didn't. I didn't realize how much joy there was going to be in terms of helping other people and figuring out how they learn and what they can learn and seeing them have success. So that was kind of what drove me towards the teaching profession and why I'm still here and enjoying it.
Well, we appreciate it, and I can see that you have a very successful team. They came off really strong in that opening round. Let's see if it continues. Thanks for being here. Well, now it's time to continue with our competition with today's one-on-one rapid fire, where we have a chance to meet our individual players and then pit them against each other. So first, let's say hello to Sim Spurrier. You have been here before, so you know how to play. You are a sophomore, and there's so many websites out there. There's blogs, there's apps, and I mean, there's a plethora of them. But you found one that I have not heard about that you have a passion about.
Yes. So I enjoy reading XKCD. It's a webcomic that is a fun blend of science and facts and humor, and so I just really enjoy it.
And I just want to make sure it's something that your parents would be comfortable with you.
Yes, they are.
Oh, excellent. Okay, and now let's meet our next player, and that's from Central Dauphin, and that's Caitlin Wilson. And I guess in a jocular way, I could say, I want to make sure that I have the right calls against you, because you are skilled in a combative way.
Yeah, I'm a third-degree black belt in Taekwondo.
And when did you start?
When I was 8, so I'm coming up on 10 years.
Besides using that for self-defense, there are other advantages.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot about discipline and like being aware of yourself.
And focus mm-hmm. and stuff. Well, Caitlin and Sim, hopefully you're going to be disciplined and focused as we put you two one-on-one. Baldwin, Yamaha, Steinway. What musical instruments do all these companies make, Sim?
Pianos.
They do all make pianos. An abbreviated title can tell a lot about a person. A CPA is an accountant, an MD is a medical doctor. What does an individual with a DVM usually do? Well, I'm sure many of you have pets, and you may have to go to the vet. It's a doctor of veterinary medicine. And finally, about 1,900 miles long, it empties into the Gulf of Mexico near Brownsville, Texas, and Matamoros, Mexico. What is this great river?
Rio Grande.
The Rio Grande is absolutely correct. 40 to 140, a strong lead right now for Central Dauphin, but everything can change as we now meet our two captains. So first, from Lancaster Mennonite, it's a pleasure to welcome back Henry Martin. Henry's a senior, so this is your last season here with us. And as you graduate high school and you think about your future, there's a certain place that you would dream about living one day.
Yeah, I'd love to go live in Germany someday. I think the country is amazing.
But why Germany?
I was born there. My parents worked there, and I've always thought the language is really interesting.
And do you speak German and taking it at school as well?
Yeah, I'm learning it in school.
Well, that's going to be a big help. Everybody seems to speak English these days. Orion Keller. And Orion is a senior at Central Dauphin, and boy, you really helped your team handsomely in that first round of play, and I do want to acknowledge that. There's always things that we do in life that we, either our parents convinced us, our grandparents, or our friends, and it turns out to be fantastic. And this happened to you.
Yeah, I joined the school's jazz band last year, and I initially joined it reluctantly under like pressure from friends and teachers, but I ended up really liking it. And I like listen to jazz, and now I'm learning how to play the saxophone because our band directors really inspired me to like pursue my love of music.
And who is your band director? Let's give him a shout out.
Mr. Bittner.
And I'll bet Mr. Bittner's going to miss you when you graduate. Orion and Henry, let's put you two one-on-one. This city's business district is called the Golden Triangle because it's located at the intersection of three rivers, the Ohio, the Allegheny, and the Monongahela. Orion.
Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh is the city, yes. Elizabeth Holmes, founder and CEO of the collapsed Silicon Valley company Theranos, has been sentenced to 11-plus years in prison for financial crimes she committed. What did Theranos' design technology promise to accurately test? Orion.
Coronavirus?
No, that's incorrect. Sorry. Henry, do you have any idea? Henry.
Privacy?
Oh, no, it's blood. The failed design technology promised investors that it would generate accurate blood tests via a single finger prick. And finally, it is the air traffic control call sign of any U.S. Air Force aircraft carrying the President of the United States. Orion.
Air Force One.
Air Force One is correct, 140 to 160. Now let's meet our third players in today's competition. First, from Lancaster Mennonite, a pleasure to welcome back Owen Ash. Nice to have you back here. You are a sophomore this year. And we're all passionate about so many things. You know, of course, I'm passionate about Brain Busters and Quiz Bowl, but you're passionate about an activity, but I'm not sure if it's a sport.
Yeah, I'm really into unicycling. I have four of them, and I've been doing it for around 3 years or so.
So is it a sport?
Yeah, there's a bunch of different types, such as mountain unicycling, which I've gotten into.
That's competitive?
Not really.
No. So I've got to ask, because we're seeing you broke your arm, but that was not due to the unicycle.
No, okay. I was separate.
Just want to make sure all our viewers feel comfortable about that. And Connor O'Neill from Central Dauphin, it's nice to have you here. You are a senior. It's great to have you back. And when we think about students like you, and obviously on the show we're thinking about you constantly studying and sitting at your desk and reading, but you do have fun outside of school.
Yes.
What are some things that you might do?
One of my favorite things to do is disc golf, which is a sport that's kind of growing a lot more popular recently.
It is, and I see it at local parks yes. and stuff. So do you have a bag full of Frisbees? And
yeah, I probably have too many.
Do they make a difference with what kind of Frisbee?
They do, yeah. They all do different things.
All right. Well, hopefully these questions won't make too much of a difference as we put Owen and Connor one-on-one. It was established in 1701 as the Collegiate School of New Haven, Connecticut. What is this Ivy League university? Owen?
Harvard.
Not Harvard, no, sorry. correct. Connor, do you have any idea? Connor?
Yale.
Yale is the correct answer, yes, for 10 points. The word comes from the Latin for still sun. In the Northern Hemisphere, the summer one is around June 21st, and the one in the winter is around December 21st. Connor?
Solstice
is the correct astronomical term. And finally, many women are important in American history. Who is the first lady to become senator? Owen?
Hillary Clinton.
She's the one, yes. 50 to 180. We're now going to pick up the pace and play today's 60-second team lightning round. Henry, you have your work cut out for you, and I know you're poised for the big comeback with one of these three quizzes. We have Gee Whiz, High IQ, and Ease Into It.
Ease Into It.
For 10 excellent points each, let's ease into some questions about people, places, and things whose names all begin with the letter E. Henry, I take your answer as the team's answer. Sim and Owen are ready to help you along. We're gonna put 60 seconds on the clock, which will begin after I finish reading the first question. So good luck, and here we go. Einstein's famous equation for the relationship between energy and mass.
E equals MC squared.
Correct, the motto of the United States, Latin for out of many.
E pluribus unum.
Correct, it's the electronic alternative to the US Postal Service.
Email,
yes. According to the book of Genesis, she's the mother of us all.
Eve.
Yes, it was built from 1817 to 1825 to connect the Hudson River with Lake Erie.
Erie Canal.
Correct. It's what EPA stands for.
Environmental Protection Agency.
Correct. His real name is Marshall Mather. He's also Slim
Eminem.
Shady.
Eminem,
yes. This country borders Colombia and Peru.
Ecuador.
Correct. George wrote novels like Silas Marner. T.S. wrote poems like The Wasteland.
Elliot
is correct. Since 2002, this has been the common currency for most of Europe.
Euro,
yes, the part of the body where you'll find the hammer, the anvil, and the stirrup. Correct. He was the last general of President of the United States.
Ulysses Grant.
No, Eisenhower, a casino in Las Vegas, or King Arthur's sword.
Excalibur.
Correct, called the gateway to the north. It's the capital of Alberta, Canada.
Edmonton,
correct. Its formula is x squared over a squared plus y squared over b squared equals 1. That's an ellipse. Fantastic teamwork, 13 correct, 130 points came your way. That made a big difference in the scoring. Orion, it's now up to you with Gee Whiz and High IQ.
Gee Whiz.
Gee Whiz it is. If you're a Gee Whiz, you should have no trouble with these people, places, and things that all begin with the letter G. Orion, I take your answer as the team's answer. Connor and Caitlin are ready to help you along. 60 seconds on the clock, which will begin after I finish reading the first question. Here we go. A powerfully built great ape, largest living primate.
Gorilla.
Correct. The search engine that also offers maps, mail, docs,
Google.
And correct. The three-letter word can follow spearmint, chewing, and bubble.
Gum.
Correct. His travels include
trips. Gulliver.
Gulliver is correct. State nickname by the Warriors of the NBA.
Golden State,
the only name shared by a Eurasian country and the U.S. state.
Georgia.
He led the movement for the independence of India from the 1920s.
Gandhi.
Gandhi's the one. This word can precede interface, novel.
Graphic.
Graphic is correct, and violence was the other one. The only one of Disney's seven dwarfs whose name begins with G.
Grumpy.
Grumpy, the basic monetary unit of the Netherlands.
Gilder,
this branch of medicine deals with the health of women.
Gynecology.
Correct. It borders Mexico, Honduras, El Salvador, and Belize.
Guatemala
is correct. It's the part of the bird's stomach for grinding food.
Gizzard.
The gizzard, usually with grit. A small, graceful antelope of Asia and Africa.
Gazelle.
A gazelle. Iceland and Yellowstone National Park both have these eruptions of steaming
Geyser.
Water. Geysers. Well done. 15 correct. 150 points came your way. 180 to 330. It's time now to reveal today's bonus Brain Buster category. Now, during our break, our teams will wager 0 to 25 points based on their knowledge of musicals. So we'll have the bonus Brain Buster and, of course, the all-important Final Frenzy when WGAL 8 Brain Busters continues in just a few moments.
Watch all this season's episodes of WGAL 8 Brainbusters anytime on WGAL.com. Our online home also includes our tournament schedule and a chance to learn more about the show and host Rich Rosen. Go to WGAL.com and click on Brainbusters.
Well, hello, everybody, and welcome back to Studio A in our competition between Lancaster Mennonite and Central Dauphin. Central Dauphin has a very strong lead right now, but everything can change because we're heading into today's bonus brain buster. Now, during our break, our teams wagered from 0 to 25 points based on their knowledge of musicals. Let's head into the News 8 newsroom with Lori Burkholder. She has today's question. Lori, welcome to Brain Buster.
Thanks, Rich. And now here is your bonus Brain Buster question. Circle of Life is the opening number of this Broadway musical and film. The musical closes with this as well. What is the now classic show? Again, Circle of Life is the opening number of this Broadway musical and film. The musical also closes with this as well. What is the now classic show? Good luck with your answer. Now back to you in the studio, Rich.
Thank you, Lori. Good luck, team. So we'll give you about 5 seconds. I don't know how challenging this one was. I think both teams are ready. Okay, Henry, we always start with your side, and you were eager to write your answer down. And we'd like to, if you could show it, The Lion King. You are correct, and good for you for a 25-point wager. So that's going to add 25 points to your score. Orion, did you come up with The Lion King? You did come up with The Lion King, also 25-point wager. Good for you as well. 205 to 380, if my 205 to 380, if my addition is correct. No? That is correct, 355, 205 to 355. All right, everything hinges right now on today's final frenzy, this time 20-point questions. Pick up those signaling buttons and let's see what happens with these 20-point questions beginning now. It's the interest rate banks charge their best commercial customers. What is the economic indicator or rate controlled by the Federal Reserve Board? Connor?
APR.
Not the APR, no, sorry. Anybody from Lancaster Mennonite? We stumped you on the prime lending rate or prime interest rate. Who is next in this series? Sarkozy, Hollande, and now since 2017? Well, these were presidents of France, Emmanuel Macron. Star within a star, double wedding ring, lone star, and windmill blades. If you were using one of these patterns, what practical and decorative object would you be making? And that would be Orion.
Pottery?
Not pottery, no, but it's a great guess. And Sim?
Quilt.
Quilt. And quilting is a correct response. In the world of business, this artificial legal entity is a person that may be sued without its members being held liable. What body? Orion?
Corporation.
A corporation takes its name from the Latin for body. In her autobiography, Norma McCorvey writes about her role in the landmark Supreme Court decision. What case was Norma McCorvey the famous plaintiff? Orion again.
Brown v. Board of Education.
No, sorry, that's incorrect. Lancaster Mennonite. Sam.
Roe versus Wade.
Roe versus Wade, good for you. It secretes half a dozen hormones, including ACTH, TSH, and FSH. What is the major endocrine gland at the bottom of the brain? Henry.
Pituitary gland.
Correct. Let's go on a cruise. From Basel to Strasbourg to Mannheim to Mainz to Wiesenboden to Koblenz to Bonn to Cologne to Dusseldorf. Down what great, Orion?
Volga.
Oh, no. We complete the question for Lancaster Mennonite. Down what great European river are you traveling, Henry?
Rhine.
The Rhine. Two European countries have flags with a white cross on a red field. Switzerland is one. What Scandinavian country is the other? Orion.
Denmark.
Denmark. The bank clerk Krogstad, the lawyer Torvald Helmer, and his wife Nora are all characters in this Ibsen drama. What play ends with a slamming door? Sim.
Fences?
No, not Fences. Sorry. Good question. Any idea? We stumped you on A Doll's House. According to Hesiod, he was the youngest son of Uranus and killed him. He was interned.
Sim. Zeus.
No. Sorry. He was interned as Poe's, and that was, it was Cronus, Zeus's father, that we were going for. Well, that sound takes us to the end of the round and to the end of the game. With a score of 395, Central Dauphin is triumphant and will return for round two, but we hope you will return for some final words in just a moment.
Scorekeeping for WGAL 8 Brain Busters, presented by Jennings College Consulting, where students discover the right college fit for the future. We'll return after this.
Congratulations to Central Dauphin. They did a fantastic job. They are going to return for round two. Now, we say goodbye to Lancaster Mennonite. We thank them for being here, but we know we'll see them next season. Coming up on the next WGAL 8 Brainbusters, we've got two new teams, Stone Independent and Anvil Cleona. We haven't seen them for a couple seasons, so we never know what's going to happen. We hope to have the pleasure of your company as well. Thanks for spending part of your day with us, and we'll see you next time. So long.